On propaganda. We live in an era of ideological wars with mass ideologies, mass propaganda, and mass movements as their indispensable instruments. Sovereignty and national borders, war and diplomacy, peace and stability. All these notions of the 19th century have become obsolete. The nuclear weapon is not a weapon in the strictly military sense of the word, but a huge psychological factor in the ongoing ideological war. War is no longer simply military confrontation between nations, but anything from popular unrest to terrorism and guerrilla movements. And the battlefield of modern war does not confine itself to the borders of nations, but it exists in people's minds, whether in Indiana or Siberia. It takes only about 15 minutes for a missile to reach the opposite side of the globe. It takes only a fraction of a second for news to reach the same destination. Strictly speaking, there is no longer any such thing as purely internal affairs. Vladimir Bukovsky, America's Crack-Up in Orthodoxy, The American Spectator Anniversary Anthology, Harper and Row, 1987. The ineptitude of the Americans in this area is especially surprising. It is they who invented advertising, both crude and subliminal, and yet their understanding of the Soviet attitude to propaganda is infantile, and their inclination to play that particular intellectual game to good effect is small. What the Americans don't realize is that, at the turn of the 21st century, communication in the international field is one of the weapons, and I would say one of the vital and indispensable weapons. In the West's continuing engagement with the Soviet system, anyone who has studied Lenin and has learned the first three lessons about the Soviet system knows the immense importance communism attaches to agitation and propaganda, both in keeping the system on a steady keel and in subverting its supposed critics and adversaries abroad. It takes a missile 15 minutes to cross the globe, and propaganda covers the world in a fraction of a second. Vladimir Bukovsky talking to George Urban in Encounter magazine, November 1987. Soviet system has at its disposal much more instruments of political influence in any crisis, much more dimensions of fighting, to which the Western society has no response whatsoever. It simply has no means for it, no instruments at all. We could use the public opinion in the West freely. We could appeal to the left-wing spectrum of these countries, using it as a very powerful tool during the developing crisis. We could use guerrillas very easily. We could do a lot of things. And the Western side could generate only 1 out of 5 responses to our moves. They simply had no means. That's one of the frightening things that underlies the unpreparedness of the West to a real crisis with the Soviet system as it is right now, which has been developing these tools for the last 50 or 60 years, and unless we give attention to this ideological warfare and some other aspects for the Soviet Union, unless we have some capability of meeting this challenge, our future seems to be very dire. Vladimir Bukovsky at the Conservative Political Action Conference, December 1986. The Soviet population, too, has been subjected, day after day, for 65 years, to an intense propaganda campaign about this putative, hostile encirclement. The communist rulers unscrupulously exploit the tragedy of the Soviet people in World War II for the purpose of justifying both their oppressive regime and their monstrous military spending. They try their best to instill into the people a pathological fear of the capitalist world. Fortunately, the people are sane enough to laugh at the very idea. Thus, contrary to this theory, there is no paranoid population demanding to be protected in the Soviet Union, despite the best efforts of a perfectly sober and cruel government. Vladimir Bukovsky, The Peace Movement and the Soviet Union, The Orwell Press, London 1982.